with favor and regard for you, rendering you fruitful, multiplying you, and establishing and ratifying my covenant with you. And you shall eat the abundant, the old store of produce long kept, and clear out the old to make room for the new. I will set my dwelling in and among you, and my soul shall not despise or reject or separate itself from you. And I will walk in and with and among you and will be your God, and you shall be my people. I am the Lord your God, who brought you forth out of the land of Egypt, that you should no more be slaves, and I have broken the bars of your yoke and made you walk tall as a free man. This is the heart of the Lord toward you, people of God. The Lord says that 2011 was a year of chaos. It was a year of disorder, a year of disarray, a year of disturbance. But the Lord said, I had to allow those things to occur. Because 2012 is a year of excellence.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
You will excel in 2012.
All right.
So I cause things to happen in your life to prepare you. I put you in a crucible. And some of you I crushed and I ground to powder.
Amen.
Because in order for you to walk into 2012 fully prepared, fully equipped, you had to go through chaos. It's called a chaos theory. So in 2011, God allowed some things to take place. He allowed situations to take place. But this is what I heard God. He said, but you, instead of you running to me,
yes.
He said, some of you ran to others.
Oh, my God. Mm-hmm.
See, the test was designed with your maturity in mind. It was formed. It was fashioned. It was built. It was constructed with everything that you are and everything that you will be in mind. So, what? Some of you were saying, God, I can't do this. There's no way I can't go through it. But God said, you said that because you haven't tapped into who you really are.
Wow.
See, some of you are looking at your situations and your stuff through an old set of eyes.
Mm.
You're looking in your stuff. You're looking at your stuff by virtue of who you used to be. In other words, there's some of us who are still wearing diapers even though we're toilet trained. You're already grown. But you're still acting like... And how you could handle it. And you didn't leave. understanding. I would have never allowed it if you couldn't endure it. Wow. The Lord said that. Many of you know me as Savior, but you have yet to know me as Lord. And see, 12 is the number of government, divine government. And see, the Lord is looking to bear the government on his shoulders. But you can't have the government of God reigning in your life if he's not Lord. Now, what do I mean? Proverbs, what you mean? What I mean is, when we in trouble, Jesus. When we're sick, Jesus. When Pope Philip was talking about me, when stuff happening, Jesus. But what about when the storm ceases? Is he Lord? In other words, some of us only call on the Savior, but we have yet to embrace him as Lord.
Go ahead, Prophet.
This is the year where God said, I must be Lord. I must stand on the throne of your heart with my scepter, and I must rule. There's no other way. That's the way 2012 is designed. 2012 is designed for God to rule sovereign. There's no other way. And some of us are already a year behind. When you look at the number 12, 12 foundations, 12 pearls, 12 gates, 12 tribes, 12 walls, the 12 angels. When you look at the number 12, 12 is a perfect number. It's a perfect whole number. 2011 is an imperfect number. You can't divide into number 11 evenly. So God said, what I'm doing in 2012 is I've taken 3 and I'm taking 4 and I'm combining them. Now what does that mean? The Holy Trinity, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, rules supreme, and is multiplied by the 4 corners of the earth. In other words, there is a move of God that's going to take place in 2012 that's going to encompass the entire surface of the earth. That's why you had to go through what you went through. God, that's why God had to kill you. That's why he had to put you in the tomb. That's why he let the devil put a stone. Because he had to let you know you got resurrection power. You can rise up out of anything. If you was 4 days and stinking, God said you could have still risen. It's power in you. You haven't tapped into because you're tapping into power that belongs to apostle. Each of us have our own power of God dwelling inside of us. You ran to others because all you had to do was look within. I was there all the time. He said, I was there all the time. The first time I said, no. No. Why are you still wearing pull-offs? In your potty train. Why? Why are you in a high chair when you're supposed to be in a king's chair? Why? Why do you need to be spoon-fed when you can cook what you want? Why?
Better speak that.
The power of God this year will be like none other. What is taking place in 2012 is preparing the earth for the return. I could just pull it out my brain like I see it. God said I had to marry who I am with the 4 corners of the earth to produce this number 12 to show you how divine I am, how I rule, how I reign, how there's nothing that escapes my eye. Even if I don't move when you say I'm supposed to move or when you think, God said I got it. But I must be Lord. I must be Lord. I gotta sit on your brain. I gotta sit on your tongue. I gotta rule. I've got to rule in 2012. So, we've carried ourselves in times past must change. Remember I said, there must be purple carpet. God said, this is not kingdom. I don't want church. 2011 is the end of the church age as we know it.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
2012 is kingdom come.
Wow.
I gotta say it again. Some of y'all missed it. 2012 is kingdom come in its fullness. God has to be manifested in the earth realm. He's got to be manifested in marriage. He's got to be manifested in the home. He's got to be everywhere people go, they are bumping to Jesus.
Wow.
If somebody's at the pharmacy, they are bumped into Jesus. He's supposed to encompass the whole frame of the earth. It's supposed to be Jesus on the north, Jesus to the south, Jesus to the east, Jesus to the west, Jesus on the north. It's supposed to be Jesus everywhere.
Yes,
He said, I must be Lord. You can't just call me to be Savior. You can't just call me when you need to be delivered and set free. I must stand in your mind. I gotta stand in your heart. I gotta make my bed. God said, I've gotta sit on your heart. We've gotta crown him. We've got to crown him. This year is a year of coronation. This year is a year of royalty. That's why I've been on Sister Charmaine. It must be purple and gold. It must be. I'm buying spray paint. I'm buying purple tape. Everything. God says, in my mind, the Lord said, I want you to bleed blue, purple, and gold. Everything must be kingdom. The kingdom of God must be fully manifested in the earth realm. The church age has dissolved.
Yes, Lord.
It's over. For having a title. God don't care about your title.
Please talk about
he, pray God. He don't care about your title. It's sickening him. Everybody's apostle, prophet, pastor, evangelist, teacher. The great I am. The great bishop of the four sweeping command. Everybody needs a title. That's church. Religion kills. Religion fights. Religion destroys. Religion put Jesus to the cross. It was religion, the priest who walked around with the great robes. They had nothing in them. Jesus didn't have a place to lay his head, but he's healing, and he's delivering, and he's casting out. That's kingdom. It's not about a title, what you wear, what you drive. That's metal, that's dirt.
Yes.
It'll fade away. But the kingdom of God is eternal, life everlasting. Let me try to move on. So, it is necessary, it is expedient that his kingdom be manifested. In 2012. That's why your trials, they were formed with the kingdom of God in mind. Your test, that lie, that gossip, that backbite, that hypocrite was all formed with kingdom. It was formed with kingdom. Some of us missed it. Hey, we're going to 2012. We're going to the kingdom age, being churchy. And you're going to miss the favor of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
He said, I'm leaning toward you with favor.
Ah!
In other words, you want to feel God's breath against your forehead in the morning. You want to feel like the dew. You want to feel the drips of saliva coming out of his mouth. You want to feel it. He's leaning toward you with favor. Some of you are going to experience angels like you never had before. This is kingdom age. You're going to see angels like you never have before. Signs and wonders. You don't have to follow them. They're going to follow you. You'll be your own conference. You'll be your own revival. So he said, I'm leaning toward you with favor. have regard for you. In other words, I'm looking at you and I yearn. You know, when somebody loves somebody, they just want to give them stuff. It's not the stuff that show demonstrates love, but you just want to give. That's what a man of God says. If you love God, ain't this in church? It's a churchy, churchified, churchy church mindset to get mad when it's time to give. That's not kingdom.
That's right.
Kings give to kings.
That's right. Come on. Yeah.
What did the Queen of Sheba do?
Come on.
When she heard about Solomon.
Yeah.
Solomon had everything. God gave him so much stuff he probably couldn't even tell you all. But she acknowledged the regency. She acknowledged the royalty. And she gave the best she had. She was the king and she gave to the king. Abraham gave to Melchizedek. When you recognize kingdom, you give. You understand. When the woman, the Zarephath widow, saw Elijah, she said, I ain't got but a little bit, but I feel something in me makes me want to give. It's kingdom.
Come on now.
It's kingdom. So I'm leaning toward you with favor. And I'm rendering you fruitful. Now listen to this. What's happening is, some of you have sowed in 2011, and you've received a partial harvest, but the Lord said you haven't received all of your harvest yet. So on top of what's stacked up and stocked up for you in 2012, you're still going to get fat from the blessings in 2011.
Hallelujah.
He said, verse 10, and you shall eat the old store, or the abundant. What is King James? Anybody read the King James Version? You shall eat. It was the old harvest.
You just saw the surplus.
The surplus. And now look. Last year's. You going into 2012 still eating lots of my 2011. God, I can't even get to my 2012 blessing. I'm still stuck on my 2011.
Hallelujah. Glory.
He's not finished blessing you in 2011. I'm not done. So you are entering into a new year, but you still have blessings. God said, I'm not finished. So your blessings are going to transfer. Your blessings, your favor, your harvest from 2011. God said, even though your 2012 stuff is stocked up, I already got that, but you can't even get to that yet. You're going to be so preoccupied with living off of last year's blessings.
My God.
You might carry 20 some of 2012 something in 2013. I don't know. That's what the anointing is. It means fact. The anointing means fact. Whenever God does something, it's always an overabundance. He can't help it. He's God. God don't just give you a little bit of blessing. He give you blessing that you don't have room enough to receive. So I'm here at the end of 2011 and I still got my 2011 blessings. I don't have space to put all this stuff. But I'm enjoying Jesus' name. Let me try to. Gotta hurry. Gotta get through this. Y'all gotta come back tomorrow for part two. I ain't even got the part two yet. So things are changing. The dynamics of things are changing because now the kingdom of God. Everything now must represent royalty. God said, I will have nothing less. I remember something Apostle said a few years ago. Everything about you now must be kingdom. You must have a royal toothbrush. A royal, everything now about you is royalty. This time. Come on, you need to pick up something. Oh, Lord, help me, Jesus. Can you pick up your keys or pick up yourself or do something and say, this is royalty because it belongs to a king. It must be royal. My God, I got to stop there because it's almost time. So I'm changing things and I'm leaning towards you. So quit thinking everything in your womb is the devil.
Say so, right?
By all means, remain discerning. But You're going to entertain angels unawares. You're going to see shadows of things. It's favor peeping in on you, searching to see what you have need of today. It's favor leaning, following you, making sure that you don't eat your 2012 blessing before it's going to remind you of your 2011 stuff. So don't go calling nobody talking about anointing my house. It's the Lord. Not unless you're doing some freaky things, and yeah, you need some oil.